problem, it is asked that trace or copy the graph of given function f. Assume that the axes have equal scales, right? So now then use the method of example 1 to sketch the graph of f dash below it, right? So we are just, these are the graphs given to us, right? So now simply we are just you can say dropping the arrows here, right? Or you can say the projecting the graphs, right? So we can assume that this is f, all right? So this function is f for us, for everything, right? For every problem. So graph 2, like graph 3, graph 4, and graph 5, right? So here there is a function f, right? So when f is less than 0, then it will be like this. We can see that this function is actually decreasing, right? So whenever we differentiate a function, then if the function is decreasing and we are differentiating it, so it must increase, right? So, or you can say it will be just flip of this problem, or you can say water image kind of thing, but it is not possible for every point. I am just talking about this particular point, right? So this is started from here, right, decreasing, but here it will increase. This is f dash, all right? So here the graph is f dash. Okay, now again the graph is like increasing till here. After that it starts decreasing, right? So here there is a constant value, right? So for constant value the differentiation is nothing but it is zero. So that's why we are getting zero here. Okay, after that it is again decreasing. Now it increases from here again. When it starts increasing, then it decreases here. Right, so this is how we make this, this is how we plot this graph for the differentiation of f. Right, so here again our function is given, that is f, and here it is increasing, so it must decrease from the positive value, right? So here there is some kind of constant value. Why? Because this is decreasing, right? So it must be like this, and this constant value continues, so it also continues here, right? Now again this is the third part we have. You can say this is A, B, and C, right? So C is here, we can say this is going constant, so there will be constant value, right? Constant value, then after that it is decreasing, so it is decreasing, so it must turn right and remain constant, right? It is not increasing, it will also decrease, right? But it will remain constant till here, after this axis, right? This is for x-axis. Now here a semicircle is given to us as a function. Right, so it is increasing in this way, right? So when we differentiate it, we are getting a constant value kind of here, right? Similarly, like here in option B, we have got here. Similarly, we have got here like this, and this is like this. So it will increase. It is increasing all the time, right? In the semicircle, in quarter part of the circle, it is increasing, so it must decrease for the quarter part, right, of a circle. We are talking about the semicircle, all right? So now it is decreasing down the y-axis. Now here it is decreasing again, so this will be like this, and it will start increasing in the direction of y-axis. So this is how we solve this problem. This is our f dash again. This is also f dash again. And now for the f, this will be a constant value, right? So this is like a semicircle only, because half of the axis it is just going constant value, right? So we can just say that if this is a constant value, obviously we have concluded in this way, so this will be our constant value, right? So f part is very easy. It will be constant, simply a constant line going through. So this is just a directly proportional line, you can say. So this is how we solve this problem. I hope you understood the concept. Thanks for watching.